If one has to understand what the term dramatic turnaround means, then look no further than the Karnataka Assembly election results of today. It first seemed to be a comfortable win for the BJP, but when it emerged that they would be falling short of the majority mark, the Congress and the JDS wasted no time to announce an alliance. Currently, the BJP is expected to win 104 seats, the Congress 78, and the JDS 38. But interestingly, the vote share of the Congress is almost 2% more than what the BJP has got.
The people of Karnataka have rejected the last 4 years misrule of Congress, led by Sri Siddaramaiah. People of Karnataka have voted for change and given a mandate for Congress-free Karnataka. I thank people of Karnataka for this positive mandate given to Bharatiya Janata Party.
To stake claim to form the government, both the BJP and the Congress-JDS alliance have met the governor. BJP's chief ministerial face, B.S. Yeddurappa, has even reportedly sought 2 days' time to prove their majority. But what will the governor do? Well, the norm has been for the governor to invite the single largest party to form the government, which in this case is the BJP. But if one is to go by what had happened in Goa and Manipur last year, the Congress and the JDS alliance still have a chance to form the government. Do log on to the Quint to know all about these possible scenarios.
We have to follow convention, we have to look at what's been held over the course of different court rulings and try to come up with an answer. The order of preference essentially goes, the group with the largest pre-poll alliance containing a large number if there's no majority, the single largest party with the support of others, then they look at post-electoral coalitions, which is what we have here with the INC and the JDS. The Congress and JDS post-poll alliance is taking them over the numbers, but should they be considered first, or should the BJP's largest number be considered first? At this point, a lot of it is now resting in the governor's hands, and he has a lot of discretion.
Now, the dramatic turnaround in the Karnataka elections has suddenly put the focus on the JDS, which is in a position to play kingmaker in the state, as many exit polls had predicted. Their leader, H.D. Kumaraswamy, now even has a real shot at becoming the chief minister. But how would this affect the JDS's political position in the state? Is former PM H.D. Devegowda's party making a comeback? Do log on to the Quint for a complete analysis of the same. So how do we explain today's political drama in a nutshell? Well, first, it started with predictions of a BJP sweep, but suddenly the JDS and the Congress jumped to their feet. The decision of the governor remains pending, and till then, the fate of Karnataka will be kept hanging. And to catch up with all the other happenings around the world, don't forget to like and subscribe to The Quint.